I've been meaning to make this video for about a year now, and I just never really got around to it because of stuff and procrastination. So, great. Better late than ever, though. So, we're gonna do it. This is the ASUS C302 Chromebook Flip. It has actually one of the older Chromebook designs on the front here. I think the newer ones aren't as colorful. And it's a Chromebook, but it's not just any old standard Chromebook that runs Chrome OS. No, no, no. Thanks to some of the customizations I have done with this over the last few years, this device, this Chromebook, can not only run Chrome OS, but it can also run Lubuntu. And it's all thanks to the magic of dual booting. Speaking of that though, if you're watching this thinking it's a tutorial as to how you can get a dual boot setup going on your ASUS C302 Chromebook or some other Chromebook that you currently own, this video is not for you. While I will be making some references as to the kind of quote unquote customizations I have done with the ASUS C302 to allow me to get this dual boot setup going, I will not actually be making a full-blown tutorial here. What I will be doing is showcasing and reviewing what it's like to use this sort of dual boot setup on the Chrome on a Chromebook on a regular basis. It's more of a reflection slash sharing of the experiences, let's say, not a tutorial. Having said that though, I do intend to make a video, a separate video, that will actually be a full-blown tutorial demonstrating how you can get this sort of dual boot setup going on the ASUS C302 Chromebook Flip. So if you're interested, make sure to hit that subscribe button. If everything goes as planned, I should have that tutorial up by sometime next week. With that disclaimer of sorts out of the way now, back to the rest of the video. Setting up this dual boot setup, I guess, on my ASUS C302 is something that I did in mid-2019, by which point I would have owned and actually daily driven this Chromebook for about 2 years. The first 2 years of using this ASUS Chromebook was spent using it with solely Chrome OS, and it was fine for what it was. I was a college student at the time, and you know, I had an internet connection in most areas, so I didn't really have any problems whatsoever. Around 2019, though, I started to take my Chromebook into areas where I just did not have a stable internet connection, if at all. And when I'd be using it in places where I wouldn't have any internet access, I was having a lot of problems with trying to use the offline applications that existed for Chrome OS at the time. These offline applications included web apps and Android applications, and you know, after a few bitter experiences here and there, I really started to desire having an ability to run Linux applications, which tend to work well offline, on this device, and I start to explore my options in regards to how I could get this done. Now I say exploring my options to get Linux apps working on the ASUS C302 Chromebook, but there weren't a whole lot of options to do this type of thing on a Chromebook at the time. You know, there were generally three. First, there was Christini, the ability to run Linux apps within Chrome OS. This was a brand new feature for Chrome OS at the time, and it was unavailable to the ASUS C302, and actually wasn't available at all to the ASUS C302 until quite recently, which I also made a video on. Secondly, there was Crouton, a third-party script that allowed users to get Ubuntu and other Linux distros to run parallel to Chrome OS. This was an option available for the C302 at the time, and I think it still is an option for most Chromebooks. I did try using Crouton on my ASUS C302 Chromebook for a little bit, but it ended up being a little bit of a glitchy and unstable experience, hence why I ended up rejecting it as a potential option to fulfill the needs that I had at that time. Thirdly, there was the option to create a dual boot setup where I would have the option to either boot into Chrome OS or another Linux distro on the device. This third option, while not as easy as Christini or Crouton, was an option that I felt fit my needs pretty perfectly, so I went through with the installation steps, which broadly speaking involved enabling developer mode on the C302, updating the RW legacy firmware with the Mr. Chromebox Tech firmware utility script, and then using the CHRX script to both partition the drives and install Lubuntu in a dual boot appropriate fashion. Once again, this isn't the tutorial, so I won't be going into full detail as to what each of those steps are like. When I went through this initial setup process, I ended up installing Lubuntu 19.10 on my device. One, because I was pretty familiar with that Linux distro, and 2 because it was the latest version of Lubuntu available at the time. Lubuntu 19.10 is actually no longer supported in the year of in the year 2021, but at the time in 2019, it was the latest version. Now, after installation, I regularly use my C302 Chromebook with the steel boot setup for about an year, during which I would switch between using Chrome OS or Lubuntu depending on what I would be doing at the time. During this year of use, though, I ended up using Lubuntu on the ASUS C302 quite a bit. And it was mainly because I just had a really good time running it on this device. I basically didn't have any issues whatsoever running basic Linux applications like LibreOffice, Firefox, etc. Basic stuff like web browsing, browsing social media, checking out YouTube videos, and watching shows from Crunchyroll, Hulu, etc. all worked fine. I'm not much of a gamer, but I was able to get some light games like Super Tux Card going and working well as well. I was even able to get some of the more intensive apps like GIMP and the Kden Live Video Editor to work somewhat well too. With only 4GB of RAM and a Core M3 processor though, there was a limit to the kind of stuff that I could do with those sort of applications. Even with that sort of limitation though, I found that the device handled multitasking pretty well and didn't fail to keep up with my day-to-day tasks. Perhaps this shouldn't be so surprising since Lubuntu is a very lightweight Linux distro and my day-to-day tasks aren't particularly intense, but I was impressed nonetheless. Needless to say, the initial goal of getting usable desktop applications on the ASUS C302 was easily fulfilled with Lubuntu running on the ASUS C302 Chromebook Flip. I've been relatively positive so far with this video, but there were definitely some downsides to running Lubuntu 19.10 on the ASUS C302 Chromebook. The major one was the hardware-related problems I had with the C302 when using Lubuntu. With factory or default settings, for example, both the speakers and the headphone jack would not be recognized by the system, meaning I would not get any sound out of it. I also had a similar but less troubling or serious problem with the trackpad, which just did not work as well in Lubuntu as it did in Chrome OS. There were workarounds to these hardware problems, like you could connect a pair of Bluetooth earbuds to the C302 when using Lubuntu, and that would take care of the audio problem to a certain degree, but they weren't ideal, let's say. The Gallium OS community and others in the Linux community had also found certain fixes to these problems as well, but these solutions didn't always work. The hardware downsides that came with using Lubuntu on the ASUS C302 was what really ruined it for me. There were other downsides that I will get to in a second, but using Lubuntu and dealing with the audio and trackpad problems really made me yearn for the more polished experience that I would get when using Chrome OS on the ASUS Chromebook, which makes sense since Chromebooks are made to be used with Chrome OS, but it was something that really annoyed me anyway. Other downsides include encountering random suspension errors, dealing with glitches within the KDE desktop environment, having to deal with long boot times, which were ridiculously long when booting into Lubuntu, and randomly encountering boot loops from time to time. Now, the boot loops weren't so serious, like restarting the system would get rid of it, but they were annoying. There were certainly fixes or temporary fixes to these problems as well, but they did negatively affect the overall experience I was having with Lubuntu on the C302. To be fair, a lot of the downsides I just described are not necessarily unique to the ASUS C302. In fact, a lot of those same issues will come up when trying to run Ubuntu or another Linux distro on any kind of new Chromebook or any kind of Chromebook that has been released since 2017. It's just, you know, there are a lot of problems with trying to run Linux distros on Chromebooks nowadays. Putting aside the Lubuntu 19.10 experience for a second though, I do want to mention that having the ability to dual boot between Lubuntu and Chrome OS really did make up for some of the problems I was having when using Lubuntu. The fact that I could boot into Chrome OS if I needed a more polished experience or if I needed working audio was just a really nice option to have available. Dual booting also meant that I did not have to give up on the experience of being able to use my favorite Android apps on the C302 Chromebook. If I wanted to play my favorite Android game or if I needed to use a particular Android app, I could boot into Chrome OS. If I needed to do something with a Linux app, I could boot into Lubuntu for it. It was sort of a best of both worlds type situation, and it was really good while it lasted. As mentioned previously, I did use this dual boot setup on a regular basis for about a year, after which I mainly went back to using the ASUS C302 as a Chromebook, meaning that I would mainly boot into Chrome OS. This decline in making use of the dual boot setup on the ASUS C302 had nothing to really do with the merits or demerits of using a dual boot setup on a Chromebook, and had more to do with the fact that I had just simply gotten a new Chromebook, which was more powerful and this new Chromebook became my new daily driver at that point, so I just had less of a need to use the ASUS C302. So that's my experience with dual booting Lubuntu and Chrome OS on the ASUS C302. If I were to be asked about whether or not I would recommend that others do what I did with my ASUS C302, the answer is meh. It sort of depends on who you are and what you're trying to do, and sort of depends on the Chromebook that you own. If you're someone who absolutely needs to be using an app or something within a Linux distro of some kind, and you cannot get away with using Christini, and you absolutely need to be able to do this on a Chromebook, then sure, this could be a good option for you. If you're someone who just enjoys being able to switch between a full Linux distro and Chrome OS from time to time, also might be a good option for you. If you're just someone who just really needs to be able to do some casual Linux applications here and there, though, if your Chromebook has Christini, I think Christini is the best way to do this. Because once again, running Linux on your Chromebook is not easy or simple, and there are definitely compatibility issues. Putting aside even some of the hardware compatibility issues, like, you know, whether or not audio is working, it's also possible that your Chromebook doesn't even support dual booting, because whether or not you can dual boot your Chromebook is really dependent on things like the model, the processor, etc. It's not something that anyone can really do with a random Chromebook. It really depends on the Chromebook you own. How compatible a Chromebook will be with a certain Linux distro also can depend quite a bit on which Chromebook we're talking about and how new the Chromebook is. And sure, I chose to run Lubuntu on this ASUS C302 Chromebook, and since it's a relatively lightweight Linux distro, I'm willing to bet that it will work with more Chromebooks than not, but there's really no assurance that even Lubuntu will work well on your Chromebook. It really does depend on the Chromebook in question. If people are really interested, or if they own a Chromebook that is known to be compatible with dual booting or with certain Linux distros, then you know, by all means, go for it. But yeah, it can be a bit of a hit or miss, especially for the newer Chromebooks. So with all that in mind, I just can't easily recommend that people try this out. Also, in reflection, if I were to be asked about what I would do differently if I were to freshly set up dual boot on the ASUS C302 Chromebook now, especially with some of the experience that I've had so far, the one thing that I would do differently is I would probably choose to install a Linux distro that is different from Lubuntu. Not because Lubuntu is, you know, is terrible or anything like that, but mainly because there is a certain Linux distro out there that will probably work better with the ASUS C302 Chromebook, and I'm talking about Gallium OS. Gallium OS is a Linux distribution that has been customized to specifically run well on Chromebooks. Certain tweaks and tricks and solutions of sorts have been implemented into this Linux distribution by developers. It's of course still a work in progress, and it's not the most perfect thing in the world, but there is an active and engaged community that backs and supports this effort. With how Chromebook oriented the whole Linux distro is, and with how compatible it is with ASUS C302, in hindsight, it probably would have made more sense for me to install Gallium OS on the ASUS C302 than Lubuntu. Something to note, though, while using Gallium OS with an older Chromebook like the ASUS C302, which came out in 2017, does make sense. Some of the newer Chromebooks don't actually support Gallium OS due to kernel issues, so it might not be the thing for you, or at least this is the case in August of 2021, where the latest version of Gallium OS is version 3.1. In conclusion, if there is a conclusion to this long and rambly mess of a video at this point, but in conclusion, I just really wanted to share with this video my experience of dual booting Lubuntu and Chrome OS on the ASUS C302 for a significant period of time. And I wanted to also just share this really neat thing that you can do with the ASUS C302 Chromebook. If you enjoyed this video or found it informative in any way, shape, or form, make sure to hit the like button. And if you are interested in seeing the previously mentioned tutorial as to how you can get this dual boot setup going on the ASUS C302 Chromebook, make sure to hit that subscribe button.